Welcome to CodeArt. I am Niyati Sinha and I'll be teaching you high performance computing. Okay, so the topic for today is performance of a CPU or machine. Okay, so we have learned till now from the previous lectures that how to calculate the CPU time. So we'll revise it very quickly. CPU time is the total time taken by a task, and for a task, let's say I assume that in a task there are n instructions. So to complete the whole n instructions, the time taken by the machine is called CPU time. Okay, so how it comes to be IC into CPI into T. So now how the CPU time came to be IC into CPI into T. Okay, so if I have a task T and it has n number of instructions. Okay, so the instructions are completed in some cycles. Okay, so the total number of cycles taken by the task into that cycle time, that is time taken by each cycle, it gives the CPU time. So now we have to calculate the total number of cycles. Okay, so we have got time takes CPU time is equal to total number of cycles into time taken by each cycle, that is capital T here. Okay, so now we have to calculate total number of cycles. So if I have a task, it has number of instructions, let's say n. So if it has n number of instructions, then this n is called the IC instruction count. Instruction count is the total number of instructions that are present in a task. Okay. So total number of instructions will be total number of cycles will be total number of cycles in one instruction into total number of instructions. Okay. So the total number of cycles in one instruction is called CPI and the total number of instruction is IC. Okay, so now I get IC into CPI into T as a CPU time. Okay, so now moving on. So let's say if I have a machine and let's say it takes 10 seconds to complete one task, and now I am changing something in the machine, like I am modifying some things. And now the same machine takes 5 seconds to do the same task. Okay, so which one is better? So for this example, let's assume a situation where I hire a worker to write some pages. Okay, and I have two options, two candidates. I have a candidate A who takes 1 hour for writing one page. And I have another candidate, that is candidate B, and he takes 10 minutes for writing one page. Okay, so which one will I take? Obviously, I will take the candidate B because he takes lesser time to complete the same task. Like candidate B is doing the same task in 10 minutes, whereas the candidate A is doing the same task in 1 hour. Okay, so in the same manner, how I decide which machine is better, the same way, the way is the machine which takes lesser time, okay, will be better. Because I want a better type, like the machine which is faster will be better, obviously, to do the same task. I'm not changing the task here. So the better one is the machine that takes 5 seconds. So I am using the same machines and they are giving different CPU times to execute the same task. So what changes have I done in the machine? So I can do this, like if I change the compiler, then I can change the CPU time. Okay, if I want to improve my machine, then if I use a optimized compiler, then my CPU time will obviously be increased. Okay, so now let's analyze it. Okay, so I'm writing a CPU time for my previous, like original machine. Okay, CPU time for original machine was IC into CPI into T. As I am doing the same task, the IC, that is total number of instructions, will obviously remain the same. Okay, so IC is same for both. IC is same for both machines, the original one and the modified one. Then as I am using the same machines, then obviously my machine frequency will remain same, that is the amount of time taken by each cycle will obviously remain same, that is T will also remain same for both. So now obviously as my CPU time is changing, I have seen it here that it is going from 10 seconds to 5 seconds, it is improving. Then IC and T are same, then obviously CPI will obviously change, because this my CPU time is changing and my IC and T remains constant, the same, then obviously CPI changes. Okay, so now I'm going to write the CPU time of new machine, that is modified one. That is IC into CPI into T and CPI new, sorry. Okay, so now I'm going to compare both. CPU time is here, here is 10 seconds. And CPU time here is 5 seconds. Okay, so let's say I'm going to divide both. CPU time original divided by CPU time modified. Okay, I'm writing in shortcut. So is equal to IC into CPI into T. I'm writing it from here only, okay? Then here divided by IC into CPI new into T. And I know the CPU time original was 10 seconds and the modified was 5 seconds. Okay, so 10 divided by 5. Sorry, plus 5. So now I can compare. This IC and this IC will be cancelled. This T will be cancelled. So this 5 and this. This is 2. So CPI original, that is first one, numerator one, is equal to 2 into CPI new. Okay, so my original cycles per instruction was double than new cycles per instruction. Okay, so now if I'm taking right now, if I'm doing 5 cycles per instruction, okay, I have to complete one instruction and that is taking 5 cycles. Then my original instruction was taking 10 cycles to do the same instruction. Okay. So this is how we compare. And the later we'll use a term called speed up. And this is the basics that why we use speed up. Okay. This is the foundation of that. So in brief, what we learned today is for a machine instruction set architecture, we are using a fixed one. CPI can be changed by modifying a compiler or changing the compiler. So if I want to improve the CPI time, then obviously I have to use a much more optimized compiler. Okay. So let's see very quickly what we have learned today. We have revised how to calculate the CPU time. Okay, then for a machine we have compared the CPU time for the same machine which has been modified to do the same task. Okay, so the machine that takes lesser time to do the same task comes out to be the better one. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.